Assalamualaikum, salam sejahtera. Anda masih bersama saya Syaf Syukri dalam Rupawan. Dan untuk episod terbaru kali ini, saya menampilkan seorang jelitawan yang pernah saya tampilkan pada tahun lalu. Jika tahun lalu kita kongsikan debaran dan juga persediaan sepanjang untuk mewakili negara ke pentas Mrs. Malaysia yang diadakan di Amerika Syarikat, tetapi kali ini beliau telah berjaya pulang semula dengan kejayaan yang saya kira cukup besar dalam arena Ratu Cantik Negara, berjaya merangkul tempat ketiga dalam Mrs. Malaysia World. Dan bersama saya sekarang ini ialah Kokilam Katrivelu. Sekali lagi, hello Kokilam, how are you?
Hello, hi. Terima kasih Rupawan untuk datang, sudi datang rumah saya.
Terima kasih sekali lagi Kokilam dan tahniah daripada pihak Rupawan dan juga Astrawani dan juga seluruh rakyat Malaysia atas kejayaan Kokilam baru-baru ini. Jadi Kokilam, mungkin boleh Kokilam kongsikan bersama penonton Rupawan bagaimana pengalaman sepanjang berada di Las Vegas Amerika Syarikat?
Memang tak sangka lah yang Kogi akan menang. Tapi persediaan tu memang I would say was incentive when I was here in Malaysia because macam persediaan untuk catwalk, lepas tu untuk make sure saya punya baju tu, you know, it's up to the par yang mereka inginkan. So everything was memang cabaran tu adalah. And I would say memang saya rasa Kogi tak dapat menang kalau tak ada sokongan daripada rakyat Malaysia, kalau tak ada sokongan daripada I punya director, national director, Datin Harvinkor dengan Datuk Mohandas. Kalau tanpa mereka, I rasa memang it's difficult lah, I would say, yang Kogi dapat menang ni, because with all the sokongan dan juga sumbangan daripada sponsor-sponsor, Kogi dah.
And then you did it.
Yes, very I did it.
Okay Kogi, mungkin Kogi boleh kongsikan sebab kita jarang ada pengalaman sebegini di mana kita hantar peserta untuk mewakili Malaysia dalam pertandingan Ratu Cantik dan jarang untuk dapat tempat pertama, tempat kedua dan tempat ketiga. Dan Kogi berjaya memecah, saya kira macam memecah tradisi untuk era yang terbaru ini. Jadi mungkin Kogi boleh kongsikan, adakah Kogi sudah meramalkan kemenangan tersebut?
Sebenarnya, to be very honest, untuk terus terang, memang Kogi tak ramal ni sebenarnya. Kogi bila dah sampai kat Vegas, saya rasa memang cabaran tu, I mean the competition lah, competition tu memang very sengit. It's because bila saya tengok daripada negara lain, when they come in, they are well prepared. I rasa lagi prepared daripada Kogi. So bila I tengok mereka, I dah rasa macam, boleh ke ni? Because of their, you know, they are very well versed, you know, they can speak very well and they can do the catwalk, very super confident. So I was like, dekat mereka tu mungkin, I rasa kalau you tengok, Kogi is one of the smallest contestant sebenarnya daripada semua tu. I was very small. And I was like, kecil juga saya daripada mereka because tengok semua tinggi-tinggi kan. So memang I tak ramal lah, okay. Tapi what I did is I gave my best. Because to be very honest, Datin Harvinkor, my director, sebelum I pergi, dia dah cakap, you make sure you bring back something. So I was like, okay, I'll try my best. So bila I pergi tu, I gave my 100% lah. You know, I really did lah.
Okay, mungkin Kogi boleh kongsikan juga apa antara cabaran yang paling sukar, yang paling mencabar sepanjang berada di sana. Saya dimaklumkan ada 38 negara yang turut serta dalam edisi kali ini. Jadi apa cabaran yang paling sukar kali ini Kogi?
Sebenarnya sebenarnya cabaran tu I would say time management kat situ, because kita ada back to back, kita ada events that they have set, kita ada schedule. So mereka dah bagi kita macam pagi kena buat apa, petang kena buat apa, evening. So the whole day we were busy. And you tahulah kita dah in beauty pageant, make sure muka kena cantik, rambut always there. You know, pakaian pun kena, you know, up to what they wanted and all that. So memang tak boleh selalu pakai baju sama je. So we had to change and all that. So they gave us time. Mereka memang bagi kita masa untuk salin baju, bersolek and all that.
But it's just semua that, sendiri eh?
Kogi buat sendiri. So towards the end, memang Kogi dapat daripada makeup artist kat situ lah. Alicia, dia tolong untuk buat makeup untuk Kogi kat situ. Because towards the end, I rasa memang tak sempat. Tapi when I went there, beginning, I did my own makeup, I did my own hair and all that. I manage myself lah. But if most of them who kenal Kogi, they know that I'm a very simple person.
Yes.
I don't really like do diva kind of hair or diva kind of makeup because I like to be simple sebenarnya. So when I was there, memang I was myself. I didn't turn into another person. I was just myself.
Bagus. Itu yang bagus sebab orang kata kita kena ada apa ni membawa diri kita, perwatakan diri kita sendiri untuk ditonjolkan, tak perlu nak mencuba jadi orang lain.
Okay. Betul.
Jadi Kogi, okay, Kogi boleh kongsikan juga ya bagaimana tentang persediaan Kogi dari mula dimahkotakan sebagai Mrs Malaysia dan saya rasa sebelum itu saya dah ada temu bual dengan Kogi juga. Kogi ceritakan bagaimana Kogi melakukan workout di gym dan juga latihan untuk komunikasi. Mungkin Kogi boleh kongsikan juga.
Sebenarnya Kogi mula selepas Kogi dah menang, so I had a schedule because kan sebagai wanita yang sudah berumah tangga, ada anak-anak tiga. So yang penting tu kita nak arrange time management tu. Kogi dah buat time management, okay, bulan ni nak buat apa, bulan depan nak buat apa and all that. And was very supportive because my director was giving me the guide lah. Dia memang bagi saya guide what you need to do and all. So when we talk about apa yang Kogi telah buat sepanjang tu is like of course the catwalk session, then nak dapatkan baju and apart from that I did a bit of video charity as well because I worked with the orang asli in Malaysia is Sabah. I went to negeri Sabah. Saya pergi negeri Sabah and I worked with some of the orang asli kat situ and also I visited this place called Pakos. All right, and so I kind of like it's just to build my knowledge and also you know on my social environment. Okay, so I wanted to know what else that I can get into my you know do what else that I can get myself into lah I would say. So yang tu Kogi pergi kat Pakos, then apart from that of course buat persediaan untuk pergi ke negara Vegas tu macam we need to find a national costume, we need to make sure we find a proper design designer for my evening gown.
You yourself choose the design for
that? Sebenarnya my evening gown designer tu I had Jimmy Koto and also Mio. So Mio as well, Mio Koto as well. So they the one who kind of helped me out with my evening gowns and all. Lepas tu on for my national costume daripada Ritz Bridal Koto. Mereka daripada JB sebenarnya. So that one Datin Harvin helped me with untuk national costume. So kalau tengok national costume Kogi, it's more to bunga raya, bunga besar. Cantik-cantik. So and I had like a fusion buat daripada baju batik. Dia sebenarnya batik daripada material kain batik. They did like a gown. Lepas tu dan juga bunga raya. So bunga raya kat kepala cantik besar tu. So I was like one of the big bunga raya kat situ lah.
So Kogi, mesti kan kalau dah ada di sana banyak perkara ataupun tentang banyak perkara tentang keunikan Malaysia khususnya nak dikongsi kepada peserta-peserta di sana yang ada juga bertanding dengan Kogi. Jadi apa yang Kogi kongsikan kepada mereka tentang Malaysia?
You see, Malaysia is a multi-race country. Okay. And we hidup memang harmony. Right? So kita memang bila saya cakap pasal Malaysia, when we had a session when we talk about apa yang unik tentang Malaysia, of course you know the bangunan yang you know yang tinggi, KLCC, selain daripada tu you know the environment kat situ, the food. So I was telling about how the food is you know differs from you know Vegas, differs from the other countries as well. So we were sharing about that and on top of it the people here in Malaysia. So we are Asian and you know Asian is very caring sebenarnya. We are very caring, we are very I would say we are very friendly as well. We are very friendly. So we welcome people. So I was sharing about how Malaysian we welcome everyone, you know, and how you know how caring we are and so I was explaining about how Malaysia a beautiful country which we have three races, main races. We have Chinese, Indian and Malay who live together and you know. So ini semua saya, bila saya berkongsi dengan mereka, they were like, wow, you know, that's so nice, you know. Your country, you all have different races and you all live together and you all work in this, you know, together and you know, it's so nice, it's peaceful, different, right? Peaceful and all. So that's something that I shared with those the other contestants. Memang all the countries they have a different different kind of race and all that. But Malaysia is like different, you know. So and it's an Asian country, right? So a lot of places to visit, places to you know they can find food, food heaven. So yeah.
Okay, Kogi. Itu tadi perkongsian yang menarik juga daripada Kogi. Jadi mungkin Kogi boleh kongsikan juga untuk pentas akhir tu bila nama Kogi diumumkan sebagai salah seorang finalist. Apa yang terdetik mula Kogi? Sebab saya nak tahu ni sebab jarang-jarang perwakilan kita dapat menerima pengiktirafan yang cukup tinggi seperti itu. Dapat top 3, top 5. Jadi sewaktu nama Malaysia diumumkan tu, apa yang bermain di fikiran Kogi
ketika itu? Kogi cakap flow dia dulu ya. So sebenarnya mereka ada hari Khamis, kita punya final was on Saturday, hari Sabtu. Tapi di sini mereka was live on hari Ahad because of the timing dia. So kat situ hari Khamis they had a close up interview sebenarnya. Close up interview ni dia carry markah 50.
Okey. Apa yang ditanya tu Kogi?
So dia sebenarnya dalam close up interview mereka ada dalam 6 meja yang they have our judges. So mereka akan duduk kat situ. So apa yang kita buat ialah we have to go and sit at each table. Kita diberikan masa. Kita kena duduk setiap meja and kita kena memperkenalkan diri kita. Kita kena cakap pasal apa yang kami sedang buat di negara at the moment and also and also about what are we going to achieve and all that. So we were sharing eventually and they ask us question. What you think about like certain questions lah Kogi can share. They think there's one they ask, what do you think about drugs consumption? Okay, apa yang pengambilan dadah? Okay, yang sangat membahayakan diri and all that. And that's there. Then they ask, this more about knowledge lah. And mereka juga ada tanya pasal kalau Kogi menang, okay, what I will do. And diri saya, they ask about myself, kenapa you masuk pageant ni, you know, what was your interest and all that. So Kogi bila mereka tanya soalan ni, I was very to myself. As I think people kind of like know me, I'm a person who want to be myself. So when I spoke to the judges, I just said the truth and I was myself. So saya rasa mereka menilai daripada situ juga. So that was the score yang mereka bagi. Kita ada 6 meja. So every 6 table tu kita pergi duduk, tanya soalan, we jawab and all. So when we come to 1-to-1, Kogi is a bit confident sebenarnya. Memang I was a bit confident when I spoke to setiap judge tu. Memang Kogi rasa confident lah bila Kogi memang bercakap dengan mereka tu. So so that was there. So selepas hari Khamis tu kita ada close up interview. We had prelims. Prelims hari Jumaat. So prelims ni yang mereka sebenarnya bagi markah penuh. So mereka ada bagi markah 25 untuk swimming suit round, baju renang. Lepas tu yang lagi satu ialah untuk evening gown. So masa tu Kogi pakailah my evening gown and also my baju renang. I think that's where I got markah kat situ. Then finals is the next day, Saturday. So Saturday was the finals and ini debaran Kogi kat situ. So bila dah semua orang dah berdiri kat situ, when they call us out, kita dah memang what's this line up dah situ kan. When they said kita nak announce top 12. So bila mereka cakap nak announce top 12 tu, honestly lah, Kogi tengah berdiri kat situ kata, please lah, at least top 12 lah. Disebabkan because of like I dah bawa negara, you know, I am nama Malaysia. You know, I've brought my country kat situ. So at least I want to achieve something.
Betul.
You know, to show that I've done something. So memang kata at least dapat 12 lah. You know, I was memang macam tu. Kogi was like at least dapat 12. So bila mereka dah panggil Kogi dekat, when they said top, mereka panggil saya pada nombor 10 sebenarnya. when they said Mrs. Malaysia, I'm like, oh sedap, okay, dah dapat lepas, okay, you know, very happy. So dah gembira, okay. Then I kata, okay, dapat 12 dah, happy. So dah masuk 12, then they announce top 6. Daripada 12 tu, mereka mereka memperkenalkan kita. Selepas tu, mereka panggil top 6. So bila mereka panggil top 6, memang Kogi was like, not sure. Mungkin atau tak mungkin. Because dah top 12 tu semuanya hebat-hebat. Betul. Sebenarnya. So, I rasa mungkin tak mungkin. Tapi I macam cakap dengan diri I lah, okay lah. You know, top 12, I'm happier.
Betul.
So, when they call top 6, mereka panggil I nama terakhir.
Okay.
Okay, I was nombor 6 sebenarnya. So, when they call Mrs. Malaysia again top 6, I was like, wah, not bad, Kogi. Asal not bad, Kogi. Okay, very happy. I was honored. Eventually, I was honored as well because I asked myself, among the 12, now I'm picked on top 6. So, so I memang I rasa happy, memang perasaan Kogi rasa honored and all that because they are identifying me.
Betul.
They are identifying Malaysia.
Betul.
So I was very happy in fact. So bila top 6 mereka dah panggil tu, then they asked a question to everybody. So mereka tanya satu soalan. I think generally it's a general kind of question that mereka nak
different question, different. Right?
No, it was all the same all question. The same. Untuk top 6, it was all the same question mereka tanya. So mereka tanya yang tell us one thing about yourself yang judges kat situ masa tak tu tahu. Tak tahu mengenai diri you. So masa tu Kogi strike is about me, about how Kogi is passionate doing something. I have this thing, it has been always there. People yang orang yang kenal Kogi mereka tahu when I do something I'm always passionate. So I will try to put my, you know, heart and soul in it. Okay, so Kogi cakap yang I'm very passionate. Okay, I'm a very passionate person. Dan juga Kogi memang teringin bekerja dengan Mrs. World platform. Disebabkan saya tengok Mrs. World platform ni adalah platform yang boleh memberikan manfaat kepada banyak orang kat luar tu. Wanita, kanak-kanak dan all that. So I said I'm looking forward to bekerja dengan Mrs. World.
So that was your answer.
That was my answer.
Okay, Kogi, so kita berhenti dulu sebab kita nak berehat seketika. Kita akan sambung sebentar lagi dan teruskan bersama Rupawan bersama saya dan Kogi Lam Katri Melu. Bertemu sekali lagi dalam Rupawan dan saya masih bersama Mrs. Malaysia Kogi Lam Katri Melu atau Kogi. Okay, Kogi. Sebelum Kogi nak teruskan tu, saya nak Kogi tunjukkan apa yang Kogi dapat semasa diumumkan sebagai pemenang tempat ketiga tu, Kogi.
Kogi dapat medal. Okay, medal yang menunjukkan Kogi was second runner-up.
Okay.
Dan juga Kogi dapat extra gifts and all that. So that one is daripada Mrs. World lah.
Jadi Kogi, dari top 6 ke top 3 tu, mungkin Kogi boleh ceritakan bagaimana debaran tu Kogi.
So bila dah mula top 6, when they dah announce kita top 6, kita dah turun bawah, dah beritahu memang mereka tanya soalan untuk all top 6. Tell us one thing about about yourself yang juri tak tahu. So bila mereka tanya, Kogi cakap yang Kogi is very passionate person, looking forward to work with Mrs. World platform because understanding the platform is such as it is I would say it's a platform that memang boleh bagi banyak manfaat kat orang luar sebenarnya. You know, wanita dan kanak-kanak kat luar kalau you are there. So memang I said that, you know, I'm looking forward to work with Mrs. World platform. So that is what my answer was lah basically. So apart from that, top 3 pula sekarang. So bila mereka cakap pasal top 3, so Kogi, when they announce first is South Africa, then second mereka announce Mrs. Vietnam, then third baru Kogi. So bila dah kat situ, Kogi was standing there, was like, okay, next siapa kan. And memang all the top 6 was all handa-handa sebenarnya, all were, you know, equally good and all. So I never expect lah, memang Kogi tak sangka sebenarnya. So bila mereka dah panggil South Africa, mereka dah panggil Mrs. Vietnam, then bila mereka nak panggil I tu, you know, tempat last kali, I rasa that was the last place that all the other contestants semua was nak. Like yeah. nak to be there,
betul,
you know.
Betul.
So I boleh faham perasaan tu nak to be there. Hmm. Alright, when they announced me, I was so shocked. Uh-huh. I was so shocked. I was speechless. I was like, alamak, I nak cakap apa ni? Now I'm very sure they're gonna ask top 3 question and all that. I was like, oh no. I'm like, wow, you know, I was like the wow factor. Sebenarnya kat situ I dah rasa dah menang dah sebenarnya.
Betul, betul. To be in top 3 is not that easy sebenarnya. Sebab you competed against like ramai contestant yang besar, yang ramai. Jadi untuk berada dalam pusingan 3 teratas tu cukup membanggakan. Jadi Kogi, apa soalan ditanyakan dalam pusingan top
3? Top 3, they ask us kenapa you rasa you deserve to win. Kenapa you rasa you deserve juri punya vote undian untuk diri you. So bila mereka tanya soalan tu, honestly I was a bit kaku kat situ sebenarnya. So because I tak expect, betul, you know. So but I said that you know, I just said that, you know, kenapa disebabkan saya memang boleh pegang that particular role, dan juga saya akan memberikan my 100% lah. So I said something like that and I told them that, you know, it's just that platform Mrs. World ni adalah besar, and orang yang memahami platform tu akan memang ingin bekerja dengan that particular platform. So I said something like that.
Tapi dan mungkin tapi walaupun Kogi dapat tempat ketiga tu dah cukup besar sebenarnya untuk Malaysia. Sebab Kogi perlu tahu dan ataupun penonton perlu tahu sebenarnya Kogi kita bertanding dengan berada di peringkat top 3 bersama dengan negara seperti Afrika Selatan dan juga Vietnam. Dua nama cukup besar dalam pertandingan ratu-ratu cantik sebelum ni, cukup menyelah, dan Vietnam saya boleh katakan sebagai beauty powerhouse juga sekarang ni. Betul. Jadi Kogi, Kogi melihat kemenangan Miss Vietnam dinobatkan sebagai Mrs. World. Kogi rasa bagaimana? Adakah dia sebenarnya layak untuk menang ataupun Kogi rasa macam I should be there?
No, honestly, Mrs. Vietnam, sepanjang kita punya journey kan, normally when we have this pageant week and all that, memang kita akan mengenali setiap peserta kat situ. And they are all my sisters, you know. Because setiap orang ada different kind of personality.
Betul.
And you know, to be very honest, I kind of find that selepas dah masuk pageant ni, I ada banyak adik-beradik. Betul. I ada banyak kakak, I ada banyak adik. You know, it's like that kind of feel because of kita kat situ, competition is competition, tapi we all feel like a family kat situ sebenarnya. So, Mrs. Vietnam, to be very honest, Mrs. Vietnam was one of my buddies sebenarnya kat situ. So, we are always together lah. Kalau you tengok, kita ada banyak gambar bersama, we are always together and all that. So, it's just that she's so nice. She's super nice, soft-spoken, super nice, confident, and she's pretty as well. And I honestly feel she does deserve that particular role. And I think dia memang boleh contribute, okay, back to the society. And I feel that she can make Mrs. World platform another, you know, boleh bawa ke another level, right? Betul.
Jadi perancangan Kogi selepas ini, pastinya Kogi nak pastikan mesti Datin Harbina pun sudah memberikan amanah yang cukup besar kepada Kogi.
Betul.
Untuk mencari wajah Mrs. Malaysia yang baru. Jadi apa strategi Kogi selepas ini untuk memilih mereka yang benar-benar layak dan mungkin boleh mengatasi prestasi yang Kogi capai sekarang?
Sebenarnya, to be very honest, apa yang Kogi look at now currently is, of course, kita dah buat poster nak keluar daripada masuk Facebook and all that. We are going to, you know, publish shortly for all the applications to come in. So, apa yang penting ialah we need somebody who is committed. We need somebody who wants to be there at that particular role, not someone who comes in just, you know, for the sake of name and fame. Sebenarnya name fame ni wherever you go you can take in, but what's important is whether are you committed, would you want to, you know, put yourself there and, you know, give your 100%. Because untuk orang yang mengenali Mrs. World, Mrs. Malaysia platform ni, it's a platform where you need to work closely with women, you need to work closely with children and all that. And another thing is, you can do wonders sebenarnya. So, kebanyakan orang, you know, they feel that masuk pageant is just, you know, beauty. But this is apart from beauty. This is more than that sebenarnya. So, we are looking for somebody who will have that kind of charisma, who wants to come in and show that, you know, they can make a difference in the society out there. So itu yang we are looking forward lah.
Okey. Apa-apa Kogi, terima kasih kerana sudi bersama dengan Rupawan untuk episode kali ini. Tapi sebelum tu saya nak minta Kogi sampaikan pesanan khas kepada ibu-ibu dan wanita-wanita di luar sana dan kongsikan kepada mereka tiada apa yang mustahil dalam dunia ini, Kogi.
Betul. So ini just nasihat Kogi kepada semua wanita di luar situ, semua ibu-ibu kat situ, that don't limit yourself. Jangan limit yourself sebenarnya. Sebenarnya kita wanita ni memang we can multitask sebenarnya. We can do anything as long we put our, you know, heart and soul there. Betul. So apa yang Kogi nak cakap ialah make sure you decide what you want in your life. And you keep on, trying to find a way to achieve your goals. Because I feel lah, wanita ni ada, mereka ada kuasa besar sebenarnya.
Magic.
Kita boleh buat magic.
Betul.
So it's all about yourself, making yourself happy so that everybody around you is happy as well.
Betul. Okay, baiklah, itu dia tadi kata-kata hikmah yang dikongsi oleh Kogi. Apapun, terima kasih. Dan tahniah Kogi atas pencapaian yang cukup cemerlang dan kita harapkan agar pewaris ataupun Mrs. Malaysia World yang seterusnya akan berjaya mungkin mengatasi pencapaian yang Kogi telah lakukan sekarang ataupun mungkin lebih cemerlang di masa akan datang. Apapun, kita ucapkan terima kasih sekali lagi kepada Kogi kerana kesudian untuk bersama kami dalam Rupawan. Dengan itu, saya Chef Chukri dan kita bertemu lagi minggu depan di hari dan waktu yang sama bersama banyak lagi perkongsian menarik. Dengan itu, saya Chef Chukri. Assalamualaikum. Bye.